I also brought Al-Quran to space. I do read about 20 pages every day in space, and when I came back, I gave one to the Prime Minister of Malaysia, and the other Al-Quran I gave it to my beloved mom. So, to me, it's important for us as Islam to do our responsibilities no matter where we are. There's no excuses. But Islam is a way of life. It's not just about praying. It's not just about fasting and so on. It's about how we live our life. It's all in our soul, in our heart. And I encourage to all of you Muslim brothers and sisters to work hard, to be united. When I was on board space, on board the International Space Station, it doesn't matter where you're from, it doesn't matter what country you are from, it doesn't matter what religion you are. We respect each other's religion. And when I came to California, I realized how the Islam brothers here are so warm, so caring and so passionate. I think I take my life for granted in Malaysia because Malaysia is an Islamic country. So we are so used to all these things. But I can see here in America, Islam is such a minority, such a small group of people. I was told it's only about 8 million people all over America. So all of you have to work harder to be united and show to the world what Islam is all about. It saddens me when I see our Muslim brothers in Afghanistan, in Iraq, in Iran, they're all fighting and so on. Space has definitely changed my perspective in life. I'm not interested in small petty things anymore. I'm more interested in the global issues like pollution, like children dying, world hunger, war and things so on. So I'm hoping to work with many, many organizations, hoping to make this world a better place to live in. And I pray that all of you will succeed in life, and thank you very much for the opportunity, and work hard for the benefit of Islam. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.